At an ODM leader, Raila Odinga, have once again drummed up support for the handshake, urging leaders to shun off divisive politics which hinder development in the country. Speaking at State House, where he met Nyanza leaders ahead of his Nyanza region tour, President Kenyatta said his legacy will be a united country before his term comes to an end.
President Uhuru Kenyatta says his legacy is leaving behind a united nation and prosperous one by bridging tribal lines. Kenyatta drummed up support for the handshake, which he says created an ample environment for growth and development, on his date with cabinet secretaries and Nyanza leaders ahead of Madaraka Day celebrations in Kisumu County. Kenyatta also urged leaders to shun away divisive politics.
If we continue with the kind of politics that we have had in this country, the politics that I call start-stop, there is no developed country anywhere in the world that has ever achieved the social, political, economic aspirations of our people with a start-stop policy.
Echoing President's sentiments, ODM boss Raila Odinga hailed the Jubilee government for their advancement in infrastructure, a record which Raila Odinga says will be recorded in Kenyatta's legacy.
I say that the way to revive this economy in this country is, number one, infrastructure. Number two, infrastructure. Number three, infrastructure. I'm happy to see, Your Excellency, that your government has picked up from what we said and has actually addressed this issue of infrastructure very aggressively.
In his tour in Nyanza region ahead of Madaraka Fete, the president is expected to launch various projects which include roads, Soin Dam groundbreaking, Kibos Inland Depot, among other projects.
About two people. It is about bringing a country back on track. It is about bringing the people of a nation to feel once again that they are part and parcel of the whole. It is to remove the issue of people feeling marginalized, isolated, left out, and to encourage a feeling that existed in this country once upon a time when some of us were children, but we hear those stories, where Kenyans were proud to be Kenyans.
The meeting comes just a day after the Deputy President William Ruto called for national dialogue on various matters ahead of 2022 polls. Elizabeth Mutuku, TV 47 Nairobi.